to another video. So today's video is going to be based on Friday the 13th. Today is Friday the 13th, and I'm going to post this obviously today because then there wouldn't be no point of me making this video. But today I wanted to just do a really like cute but also spooky look for you guys. Very simple that you guys could probably do or make your guys' own twist on it. But yeah, so I went ahead and I kind of practiced this look because it had a little art in it. So I went and practiced the art a little bit. Hopefully I can get it right for you guys. Obviously my hair cannot be tamed, you know what I'm saying? I can't be tamed, you can be tamed, from Miley Cyrus. If you know what you know, then you know. You know what I mean? This hair, I wanted it to be kind of just like loose, natural, just because like, if you are Jason, okay, on Friday the 13th, you think he's gonna be worrying about how poppin' he looks? No, he's gonna be worrying about popping people, killing people, running after people. If you have not seen Friday the 13th, you need to get a life. You just need to get a life. Without further ado, my little Jasons out there, my Freddies, and if you're team Jason, let me know. If you are team Freddy, let me know, because who do you really like? I preferably would like to go with Freddy, just because he's a little bit more gory and he's a little bit cooler, and my mom likes Freddy, so I kind of grew up on more on the Freddy side, sorry. But yeah, so my mom would decorate her house like with the big poster of the Freddy rhyme. 1, 2, Freddy's one. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, it's like a little rhyme. But she would do that, and so I kind of went on his side. Jason, he's more quiet, and he's kind of like Michael Myers, but you know, different. You know, different in the ways. But anyways, we'll get all into that. We're gonna be doing some spooky questions. I'm gonna look up some questions online and do some spooky questions, and then yeah, we're gonna get onto this makeup. It's very simple but very neat. I hope I do this right and I get it posted for you guys. But without further ado, let's get on to the video. Okay, angels, so this look, very simple, very easy. This video shouldn't be long. I'm gonna hope and try to not rush into it, but make it not so long. So, I'm usually always, you know me, I'm always gonna prime my eyes no matter what. But I'm gonna put a little bit of extra of this. It's not a primer, but I use it as a primer, so put a little bit extra more, because I really want my lids to be really, 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 really white for this look. Just because if you've seen Jason's mask, which is mostly part of Friday the 13th, I know they do like a mashup with Jason and Freddy Krueger, but when you think Friday the 13th, you think Jason, and I hope you think Jason, because I think Jason. And his mask is red, black, well, it's not black, but you know how he kind of wearing like a ski mask type of thing, and it has like the black hole. So if you were to draw that on your face, it would obviously be black. And he has those red triangles on his face. So I kind of want to recreate his mask, but in a look, you know? In a look. And this video and the next video, I will be doing eyeliner for you guys. And that means I love you guys, because eyeliner isn't my thing anymore. It used to be my thing, and now it's just not my thing. When it comes to my eyeliner, I am very like pristine, and it has to just be perfect when it comes to my eyeliner, because if it's not, then I'm crying home and I'm like hiding under a blanket for the whole week because I disappointed myself. And you don't want to disappoint yourself, you know what I mean? You just want to make yourself proud. So I want my ojos to be really white for this look. Okay, and it's really simple, guys. It's really like no technique necessary. Like, you can do this in simple steps, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so in the meantime, I am going to look up some spooky questions to be asked. This one's on a website called theodysseyonline.com, and it says 30 spooky Halloween questions. And, you know, okay, yeah. But I know it's not Halloween yet, but a lot of people are getting in the spooky season, so let's just get into spooky season already, because guys, I am so ready for you guys to see all the neat looks that I will be doing for you guys. It's going to be lit. Okay, so I'm going to take the fluffiest brush I have, and I'm gonna make sure it's really, really clean, because I'm going to be using a white color for this look. Okay, and I have my The Power of Makeup, and I'm going to be using this shade Ivy, because it's the whitest I have. Let me make sure. Yeah, it's actually the whitest that I have, and I'm just going to be taking that pretty much all over my lid with a really, 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 really fluffy brush. Okay, so first question asks, favorite horror or Halloween theme song? Okay, my favorite Halloween theme song that's been my favorite, like, since I was a little girl, is the Monster Mash. We do the Monster Mash, we do the Monster, you know what I'm talking about? The Monster Mash, I love that one. Or, obviously everyone's favorite one, obviously, is obviously Michael Myers, but who wouldn't like that song, you know? Okay, so I'm gonna do that, I'm gonna put that white all over my lid. Okay, and then I'm gonna do this side, kind of pack it all in there. Okay, I probably look like Bozo the Clown right now. I just want this look to be really, really, really white, because it wouldn't be no point if it's not white. So any whites that you guys have to do, if you guys have to mix different whites for this look, go ahead and just mix all the whites for this look. We always need white in our life. Not being racist, but I preferably like white boys, and obviously my husband's a white boy, and I will always say this always in my videos. I like white beans. I'm not trying to be racist, don't come at me. Okay, so now that you did that, I think I brought it. Oh no, I did that. Okay. So those are my two songs. Next it asks, name something you wouldn't want to run into a dark forest or an abandoned building. Wow. Okay, a good question. I think, what would I not want to run into in a dark forest or an abandoned building? Okay, actually I do know. Zombies. I would not want to run into zombies, okay? I hate zombies so much. The reason was because my husband Train to Busan or something like that. Some movie, it's on Netflix, I believe. And I watched it and it was so realistic, and the zombies on there were so, like, it hit me so hard. After I was done watching it, I was like, bruh, I was shooketh. I was so shooketh to the core that I was just like, nope, don't come at me, don't get close to me. Every scientist, if y'all hearing this, do not try to cure things. If God came up with a cure, there would be a cure. Stop trying to break things back from the dead. Stop trying to re-heal things. Okay, if I get a cut, let my body heal it up. You can stitch me up, but that's all you can do. If I get sick, then I get sick, and I'm gonna fight. I'm gonna fight for it. Do not try to, it would be great if we came up with a cure for cancer and all that stuff, but sometimes things aren't meant to be like that. So I just feel like we should just do our best to stay healthy and, you know, not try to get all these chemicals that will turn me into a motherfucking zombie, because then it's over with. Bite me now. Okay. So now I'm gonna take this really pearly white right here and put that all over my lid. Okay, let's look at the next question. Okay, have you ever played with any Ouija boy? Boy? No, I don't know. Boys aren't in my lingo no more. I have a man I'm taking. Halloween, stop coming for me, okay? Just stop. Just kidding. But no, all over my lid, like I said, to give it that shiny, like, look. But no, I have never played with a Ouija board, and I will never. If I do, I feel like my husband will be really, really upset with me, because when it comes to spiritual things like that, we do believe in stuff like that. We do believe that if you do play with an Ouija board, you aren't really talking to your grandma. You're talking to some demonic thing that is trying to act and play with your grandma and take advantage of you. And if you don't believe in that type of stuff, I'm sorry, but you'll have the chance where you believe in stuff like that. I have came in contact with things like that. My husband has, my husband's family has. There's no bueno. I'm gonna take my finger because I feel like this isn't doing justice, and I feel like. And I'm just gonna put that all over my lid just because I have, like, not messy, but kind of not neat and even. Just gonna put that in my lid. I'm gonna do it to the other side. But yes, I just don't feel like it's right. I feel like I don't recommend anybody to play with the Ouija board. Am I curious? I will say yes, I am curious to something like that. I will say that I am curious to something like that, but I rather not risk my life and kind of get in a demonic possession for something like that. That's not me. I am a Lord's child, not the devil's child. So stay away, don't come for me. I will sit here and you will stay in your house over there. That's how I feel. Just don't come for me, don't come for me. Not ready. She's not ready. She's not ready. But yeah. So. Okay. It's okay if you get a little bit undone, guy, because that's what I did. I suck. But I just feel like sometimes the finger does the job. And I'm just gonna pack that all over my lid. You know, kind of look like a clown for a little bit. But I'm not a clown. So. Okay. Okay. So. I'm going just to go back with that white I showed you guys and kind of just blend, just blend it. Okay, you know, not too crazy. Okay, next question. Favorite horror monster or villain? I don't think I have a horror monster. You would consider like The Grudge. Actually, if I have to, I think as a horror monster, I think it, I don't like clowns. I'm not preferably afraid of them anymore. Like, oh my God, like stay away from me. I just don't like clowns. Scary clowns, good clowns, I'll make an exception for you. But bad clowns, I don't, no. Don't even come at me with your perfect makeup, no. Don't even try me, because I will crit you up. But, Scary Clowns, the first movie, It. That took a toll for me as a little girl. When I watched it, I didn't even want to shower anymore. I stunk for like 2 weeks as a little girl. That's how bad it was. Not really, but I really didn't want to get near no drains or anything like that. Now the new It, Pennywiser, oh, hold on, I got something in my eye. But Pennywiser, the new It, I think is a really good movie. They did a lot of like work with him now, you know, I think it's just really good. So I would say he would have to be one of my favorites. Okay, the creepiest thing that's ever happened while you were alone. There's a lot of things that happen to me when I'm alone, so I can't really say creepiest thing. We'll just skip that one. Okay. If you were dared to spend the night in a haunted house, would you do it? No. Going back to the Ouija, no. Nope. nope, no. Because if you spend a night in a haunted house and you are vulnerable and you are weak, you will not survive. You will get some type of attachment bringing home to you, and you will be in living hell, and nobody should ever deserve that at all. If you guys seen Ghost Adventures, which is my favorite show, I am a Scout Honor Ghost Adventures queen, and my husband is too, but he's a king. We love that show, and we've seen just like a lot of things that have taken a toll. If you don't believe in, you can leave, the door is right there. It's right there, but it's okay. If you don't like it, I mean, that's you, but Ghost Adventures is a really good, I like it. They have taken things that I got attached to them. Marriages, relationships have, those type of things have ruined stuff like that for them. But it says, are you superstitious? I am very, as you can tell, superstitious as well. So my family, as my husband, like, we really believe in that. Things like that. Do you ever see figures in your peripheral vision? Actually, right now I kind of did, but I don't think, I think it's just my eye playing with me, I hope. Which urban legend scares you the most? Ooh. Okay, let's continue with the makeup. So now I am going to take a really kind of like another fluffy brush, but not so fluffy, and I'm gonna take this super like juicy red. And I'm gonna put that under, like, really high up under my eyebrows. So, legend. There's actually a lot of legends. I remember when I was little, Bloody Mary was one of them, and it was something that would kind of scare us a little bit. But honestly, I haven't heard a legend that actually really scared me like a lot to the point where I'm like, I don't want to do it. But if I can take it back to when I was like a little girl, I would have to say Bloody Mary or Lost Tapes. If you guys have ever seen Lost Tapes, and they don't show it anymore, I used to think it was like on Animal Channel or something like that. That was really scary too, and they would speak about legends like the Chupacabra. There's one about a vampire that is his wings or his arms, but I think it's his wings, are two average man length, so two average 5'5", 5'6" men, tall men, put them laying down on the floor, head to feet. In a straight line, that's how big the wings are. And it's a vampire, it sucks all your blood, yeah, not good. It's like, it's scary, but that's something that really scared, that's another thing, maybe that one, I just don't know what the thing is called. Okay, now we're gonna do the other one. I know it's different, guys, but I really like this. I just think it's a really, like, a good concept to talk about spooky questions, since it's Friday the 13th, and people always think Friday the 13th. Oh, there's also going to be a full moon today, which is really cool. Just going to make sure to really... red. Okay. And then I'm just gonna blend it out. Okay, next question. Where am I? Okay. Just wanna do a soup, like a few questions. Do you prefer gore or thrillers? Now that is a really hard question because I love thrillers, but also gore, I'm a big fan, but not also a fan because sometimes they be getting really detailed with this gore and I'm like, oh, I can see your veins, I can see sounds, and it's, I get really cringy. So it's, I'm like for both. I like both. Okay. Do you believe in multiple dimensions or worlds? I do. I'm a big Rick and Morty fan, okay? Not just because of them, but I do believe in things like that. Just because we really don't know the knowing, then we don't know the knowing, so it kind of makes people wonder what is really out there in the world. And so, like I said, we really don't know, and it's really scary. And it's okay. It's okay. What don't you know can make you stronger, or what doesn't hurt you kills you strong. I don't know. Okay, let me answer maybe like two more questions, and then I'm gonna do my eyeliner, fast forward my eyeliner, and then we will be right back. Okay, or I'm going to go off camera real quick. We'll do that. Answer like two more questions. I'm gonna go off camera, do my eyeliner, and then I'll be right back, just because I don't like you guys sitting here watching me do my eyeliner. It's not fun. But yeah, okay. So it says, ever made a potion of any sort? No, I don't feel like I should do white witchcraft or black witchcraft. I mean, it's not for me. Do you get scared easily? Yes. Yes, I do. When it comes to movies, no. But any haunted houses, or if it's realistic, yes, I do. I am a big puss, not gonna lie, when it comes to things like that. Have you ever played Bloody Mary? No. I don't ever want to come close to her. I don't ever want to see her. I don't even want to play it. So don't even ask me, because I'm shutting you down and I'm kicking you out of my house. Okay. Do you believe in demons or the devil? Going back to the Ouija board, the haunted house, yes, I do. And it's just, it's bad. I don't ever want to just come encounter with things like that. You know what I'm saying? And it's just not me. You're home alone, but you hear footsteps in your house. What do you do? I'm going to shoot you. Okay? I am going to shoot you or stab you. And I'm not lying. If it's ghost related, supernatural, I mean, there's nothing that I can do. But if someone's in my house, I'm shooting you or I'm stabbing you. Okay. Sorry, not sorry. Okay. If you got trapped in one scary movie, which would you choose? Ooh, boy. What would I choose? I know it's gonna be very hypocritical, but either the Annabelle movies, I know, because it's supernatural, I know, okay? Don't come for me, I know. Or I would do any of the Conjuring movies. I know, but those are, or Chucky. The Chucky movies, or the any of the Annabelle movies, or the Conjuring movies, okay? I know, I'm so sorry. Sorry, guys, I know I said I wouldn't fuck with things like that, but if we're speaking hypothetically, those are my favorite movies, so I would have to go for it. Okay, if you could only wear one Halloween costume for the rest of your life, what would it be? For the rest of my life. I'm trying to get to number 20 because we're on our 18th question. It's a good question. Ooh, Catwoman. Is that a Halloween costume? Can that be a Halloween costume? Catwoman. I think I would do Catwoman for sure. Actually, yeah, Catwoman. If we're talking about like any type of Halloween costume, just because I like cats, she's cool, it's nice outfits, so I'll do Catwoman. Or if we're talking about scary, I think I would have to do It. I think I would have to do It, just because, I mean, he's dealing with makeup, like he has to get ready at 5 a.m. or I'm pretty sure his makeup takes more than an hour because it's a lot of makeup he's wearing. So I would think I would be It if I could. Okay, would you ever go to a graveyard at night? I have not. Somebody that used to be in our life, he liked those things, so he would always say like, let's go on a graveyard tour or night tour, like to see things like that, and I would always want to go, but never happened. But I would. I know, I'm sorry guys, I'm very confusing. Ooh, in a zombie apocalypse, what is your weapon of choice? for sure a gun that shoots rounds really fast at the same time. And I think I would probably have maybe like a machete, an axe, something that I'm able to cut you limb from limb. Cut your head off, one clean slice, just real quick, fast. Like, that's it. Spreading the butter. Real quick, because I want you, if zombie's coming after me, I want you dead right then and there. That's it. No questions asked, don't talk to me. We're not gonna have friendly conversation about what kind of brains you ate today. Nope, not me. Okay, so that was question number 20. We have 10 more to go. And so I'm gonna do my eyeliner and I'll be right back for the finish look, guys. So be prepared in 1, 2, 3. Alrighty, angels. So I already did my eyeliner for you guys, and I really did it really big and nice for you guys. Let me see if I can closer. That's how it looks for right now. And I have a little twist. Okay, so let's keep answering questions. Would you rather go to a Halloween party or go trick-or-treating easy? I would for sure go trick-or-treating. I love candy. I love tricks and treats. I will be filling them in my bag. I would not go to a Halloween party because all I'm doing is drinking and standing there and that's it. Maybe there might be some fun games, don't get me wrong, but it's just not me. I don't go party anyways, so trick-or-treating is gonna be the way to go. Okay, so now I am going on this eye. Should I do it? Okay, so I made a really small mistake, but I've learned. I forgot to flip the 13 due to the mirror, but y'all get it, so enjoy. Yeah, I'm going to write a small little number 13 on here. Then I'm gonna write some blood drops. Oh, before I forget, I am going to take another brush and put black under my eyes. Kind of just smoke it out a little bit. I'm just gonna do the other side. I look crazy. I usually don't use black a lot. And also, before I forget, I am going to take another brush and put a shimmery red on the bottom of my eyes, just so it's just not like a straight. We want like kind of like gory but cute, just to give it that shine, guys. Not a lot, just a little bit. Okay, so that's how it looks right now. Okay. Okay. So now I'm going to take a very small brush and then I'm going to do fast forward and then finish this look off for you. Okay, so this is the finished look. Let me get closer for you guys. I went ahead and just did a little 13 for today. This is my Friday the 13th Jason inspired look. I am practicing more and more every day to practice a little bit of artsy drawings and stuff like that. But that's how it looks for now. I think it came out pretty all right for me kind of being like a little noob, but yeah, you guys, I hope you guys really like this look. I do want to finish the questionnaire real quick for you guys. So favorite scary book, La Llorona. I know that's so crazy, guys. That one has to be one of my favorite scary books. It's kind of scary, it's kind of not, but if you grew up in the Mexican tradition, that would scare the little lights out you. Like, you wanted to be home when the lights came on the streets and you were just like, don't snatch me up. I have my own mama. Don't take me. I'm good. Okay. How old were you when you saw your first horror movie? I'm going to say, I really can't remember, but I was little. It would have to be maybe like 5, 6. That's when I first saw my scary movie, and at that time I was like, this is the love of my life. Yeah. What was your first Halloween costume? I think my mom dressed me up as a cat or a leopard for my first costume, I think. I do remember I was Britney Spears at one time. I was a vampire, a witch, Gabriella from High School Musical. Step on it. Yeah. What are you going to be for Halloween this year? That's a secret. I cannot tell you guys. Because I'm going to be doing a look off of it, so I can't tell you guys. Last question. If you could have a spooky Halloween pet, black cat, owl, bat, rat, wolf, why would you want to have a room? What would you pick? I would pick a black cat. We used to have a black cat. His name was Bumper, of course. But the thing with things like that, we do believe in on Halloween nights, do never, ever, ever let your black cats, black dogs, black anything, pets that you have out on Halloween night, because it is said that, from what I was told, that people on Halloween night like to do a lot of spiritual things, a lot of ritual things, and they will like to take those type of animals because it's more common in those type of evil things. So just keep your pets inside and they'll be okay. If they destroy things, it's gonna be okay, rather than dying over some ritual. Yeah. But yeah, so I did get all these questions from the Odyssey online. You guys can go check them out because some of them do have like answers from other people, I guess, from them. But yeah, so I hope you guys really like this look. This is my Friday the 13th look. I'm just gonna get a close up for you guys one more time. And I went ahead and just paired this with like a red lipstick, and I put on like a metallic lip on top of it for you guys. Yeah, so like, comment, subscribe if you guys want to see more videos. It's okay, they're coming. Be patient. Hopefully I can get my other video that I wanted to post before this one up soon. I'm going to redo it, record it, make it look poppin' because it is for you guys. Like I say, I do like when you guys support me. Thank you guys for everyone that supports me and watch my makeup videos. I really, really appreciate you guys. But like, if I already said that, I already say like, comment, subscribe. Well, I said it now. Like I say, forever and ever, angels. Till next time. Bye. Make sure you guys stay safe today because people like to do stuff crazy today. It's just not the day to be doing crazy things. But yeah, bye.